Hi, this is Joel Persinger. I'm the Gun Guy. Thank you very much for watching my videos. I really deeply appreciate it. In this video, I'm going to go over a product that was sent to me as a T&E model that's a training system. It's the MantisX Firearms Training System by MantisX. And this is part of it, this little thing dangling on the accessory rail in the front of my pistol. But before I get into the training system, I just want to go over very quickly what some fundamentals of shooting are and explain to you which fundamentals of shooting the system works on and which it kind of guesses at. So first of all, beyond grip and stance. Now there's a lot of debate going on about the proper stance and the proper grip, and I'm not even going to get into that. But whatever one you pick that works the best for you, beyond the grip that you're going to have on the firearm and the stance that you're going to have, there are some other fundamentals that are extremely important. The first of which I would say is probably begins with sight alignment. That's how do you line up your front sight with your back sight. Then beyond that, then you have sight picture. That's lining up the target with your front sight and your back sight and lining those three up properly. So you've got sight picture, and once you've got your sights lined up properly, then you're going to put them on the target, line the target up properly. Then you have sight focus. What am I focused on? The target, the front sight, or the back sight? You always want to be focused on the front sight when you're using sights to shoot. And then you've got something called breath control. That's when you're controlling your breathing to reduce the arc of movement. You say, what the heck is the arc of movement? Well, when you're, you know, if you're alive, which hopefully you are, and I am, your heart's pumping and you're breathing and you got all your body's doing a lot of stuff and your muscles are contracting and releasing and so on to keep you standing still. You don't realize it's doing it, but that's what's holding your balance. And all those things affect your body. So when you try to hold something out there for long periods, you'll notice you can't do it without the thing moving a little bit. And that little bit of movement is called the arc of movement. So the arc of movement is the thing that you're going to reduce by controlling your breathing. And that's the whole purpose, is to try to keep that movement down a little bit, which gets into something, another fundamental called hold control. Holding that sight alignment, sight picture, and holding that gun still while you press the trigger all the way through and let the gun go off when it knows it's supposed to. So you're pressing the trigger smoothly all the way through. That's trigger press or trigger control. That's also a fundamental of shooting. And then once you've pressed the trigger, there's something called follow through. That's doing everything exactly the same way as you just did and following through without changing any of those shooting fundamentals. It's what's going to allow you to put that next shot right on top of the other one or in very close proximity. And that's a description for you of some basics of shooting, some fundamentals of shooting. The reason why I went over that is because for many decades I've been teaching people how to shoot, and these are the kinds of things that instructors work on with people to improve their shooting capability. And it depends on the type of shooting they're doing. Are they doing target shooting or competitive bullseye shooting, or are they shooting for self-defense or whatever the case might be, is going to change which of those fundamentals an instructor works on. Well, the MantisX system, that's called MantisX designed it, and it's called the MantisX Firearms Training System, is an outstanding electronic system that helps you work on some of this stuff on your own. Now, there's traditional ways for you to do it. You can do it with snap caps. You can do it with dry practice. There's lots of different ways for you to work on this same stuff. But this electronic age has really revealed some tremendous tools. And I've been fiddling around with this one, oh, I don't know, for a month or so now. And it comes with basically three pieces. It comes with this little piece, which is the sensor itself, and that attaches to the accessory rail on your handgun. And then there's an app that goes on your smartphone. It doesn't matter whether it's an Android like this one or it's an iPhone. They have apps for both. And then there's also a little plug-in cord that you can plug in to charge the system. This little thing requires recharging every once in a while. And basically, all you do is set the system up with a very simple instructions. That's attaching the sensor to the sensor to the accessory rail on your gun. And that is one limitation, by the way. If you're shooting a gun that doesn't have an accessory rail, the system isn't going to work for you because there's no way to attach it. My hope is that at some point they'll come up with some unique ways to attach it to guns that don't have accessory rails, like revolvers or older 1911s and older semi-automatics and that kind of stuff. But, you know, one step at a time, right? So once it's attached and you've downloaded the app and turned the app on, then you just have to turn the system on, set the gun down on a table for a second to give it a chance to calibrate. And then once you start shooting, the system is going to tell from the moment, you know, just before you press the trigger, where the sights were and how much movement there was in the gun when you actually pressed the trigger and the gun went bang or it went click if you're dry practicing. And then it's going to show you on the screen, did you drive the gun left or right, or did you drive it down or pull it up or pull it high right or low right or whatever. And that way you're going to be able to diagnose what's happening with your hold control. Perhaps you're not holding the gun still and your breath control needs to improve. Or maybe you're over gripping. You're squeezing with everything instead of isolating this movement. And if you're over gripping and you're right-handed, you're going to tend to pull the gun down and to the right. If you're left-handed, you're going to tend to over grip and pull the gun down and to the left. This is what firearms instructors have been diagnosing by watching people shoot and looking at where the rounds hit their targets for decades. But this system allows you to do it a little bit on your own. You know, not everybody has a firearms instructor available to them, and not everybody has the budget to go pay for private lessons. This thing will help you diagnose your shooting on your own. It's not terribly pricey, and it does, what I do like about it is not only does it give you the interface, but at the end it gives you some suggestions on what you could be doing that's causing the problem, so you know what to try to see if it fixes the problem. Now I also like the fact, because I'm a big proponent of dry practice, I also like the fact that it has a dry practice, or some people call it dry firing, setting on it. And I tried it a lot and I found that it works really, really well. So it gives me some opportunity to get the gun pointed in a safe direction, make sure it's completely clear of ammunition, the ammunition's on the other end of the house, and then do some dry practice without at the same time burning up ammunition and burning up cost of range time and so on. And then when you get on the range, now you can start seeing whether you're having a little bit of a reaction to the report of the gun going off, or you're anticipating the recoil or whatever, because you'll start to see the difference between the time that you spent dry practicing and what were the results, and the time you spent on the range and what were the results. In any case, I took it out to the range and shot it a lot, and I found that the system works extremely well. Is it perfect? No. Is it 100%? No. Is it going to fix every one of those fundamentals that I talked about in your shooting? No. You're probably going to need an instructor to work on some of those things. In fact, I would say that you're most definitely going to need an instructor to work on some of those things. Like in any other physical activity, a professional trainer is going to help you improve far beyond technology's ability to do so, or your ability to do so on your own. It doesn't matter whether it's martial arts or track and field or football or baseball or shooting. All of those things, if you can get some professional help that's outstanding, are going to help you. But this is one great tool for you to use to, at the same time, work on things a little bit on your own. In addition to things like snap caps and learning some dry practice drills and those kind of things, this is an additional system that I found is very exciting. In fact, if you're an instructor, I want to encourage you to look at it, because I'm going to start using it with some of my students who are younger students and really love the technology, and they're technology focused. So this really helps them be able to see that what I'm telling them is verified by a technological system, and then all of a sudden they begin to accept it and they go, you know what, that guy, that old bearded weirdo, might actually know what he's talking about. Now there are a couple of things I want to point out to you if you decide to use a system like this. One is, I want you to resist the temptation, once you get it set up and it's running, to take a shot. You know, there you are and you're taking a shot, bang, okay, how'd I do? Bang, okay, how did I do? Bang, okay, how did I do? You may remember I mentioned something called hold control and follow through. And in order to learn to shoot well, you're gonna have to get all those fundamentals together and then keep that same position for each and every shot. So it's somewhat similar to sighting in a scope. You wanna fire a group of shots and then look at the results. So fire 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 shots, maybe 10. I would say between 5 and 10, and then stop. Get the gun unloaded and look at the results you can see on your phone. Where did they go? Because every once in a while you have a flyer. You might find that you're doing really, really well with 9 of those shots, but you had one flyer. And if that's the one that you looked at, you'd be going, wow, my shooting's terrible. And then you'd start to over-adjust your shooting technique because you had one flyer, you made one mistake, and now you're gonna be all over the place. So get it down to 5 or 10 shots minimum, then look at it, figure out what you're doing, make a little adjustment, try to tighten it up some. But I would very much resist that temptation to look at it with every shot. Your fundamentals go to pot, your hold control goes to pot, your follow through goes to pot, and you have to reestablish everything anew every time. The other thing is you keep shooting, now you're shooting to compete with the display as opposed to just concentrating on your shooting. Anyway, thank you for watching my channel. I really appreciate it. I hope you have a great week. Please like, subscribe, and please check out the Mantis system. It's awesome. We have a link right here in the description for you to do that. I'm really enjoying it, and I'm going to use it for some students, and I highly recommend it to you. So if you want something to help you with your shooting and you want to do it on your own a little bit, or you're an instructor and you want an additional tool to use, I strongly suggest you check this one out. Also, I've got some links over here for you for Twitter and Facebook and our website. If you want to check out the blog, I do write articles up there periodically. And we try to keep you abreast of what's going on with the firearms industry and firearms news and firearms legislation and like that on the Twitter and Facebook pages. Now, if you happen to like these kind of videos, which you obviously do because you're watching it and you're not a member of the NRA, you need to be. So I'm going to put a link right here, and there's one in the description too. So if you're on a mobile device and you can't see this one, go down to the description. You can join the NRA for a year for less than the cost of one box of ammunition and add your valuable voice to the rest of ours. The NRA needs your help. We're under attack like never before, particularly if you live in a state like I do, like California. Also, if you happen to have a gun that you plan on using for home defense, or you carry a gun like I do every day and you may ever have to use it to defend yourself, you could very well find yourself in jail or being sued or any number of those things, and you're going to need some legal protection. I use a service called Second Call Defense. I like them because they front money to protect you with an attorney. They front money to get you bailed out of jail. It's not insurance that you have to pay back later, or they wait to help you in some cases with insurance companies until after you've sold your house and everything else and paid for everything. And then they'll only reimburse you if you succeed in defending yourself and you're acquitted, or you are successful in defending a lawsuit. This company doesn't do that. It's a foundation. They actually put the money out ahead of time. You're not going to have to pay it back, and their fee is very small. I use them for my family. That's why I'm recommending it to you. And there's a link right here for it if you don't see it. Once again, all of these things, if you can't make them work on the screen because you're on a mobile device, the links are in the description. Thank you very much again for watching. I hope you have a great week, and please be safe.